Welcome to the Quick Flicks video series for using generations. I'm Lindy Goodall of Lindy G Embroidery, and in this video I'll be demonstrating how to install building blocks in generations. Building blocks are one of my favorite features in generations. To turn on the building blocks bar, go to View, Toolbar, Building Block Bar, and there you see them down at the bottom. Now, Generations comes with a whole bunch of building blocks, so all of these ones up to where it starts with LG, plus a few more, come with Generations. All the ones that are prefaced with LG, and you can see I have a whole bunch, are ones that I created. So first of all, let's see how to install building blocks, because unless they're put in a certain location in a certain folder, they will not show up here. So we'll close Generations, and I've downloaded two collections from the internet. So this one is Building Blocks 10, which is Christmas Elements, and this is Building Blocks 1, which is Florals. They'll come in a zip folder. If you bought them on a CD, then they'll already be unzipped. To unzip them, you just need to do something like this. We're going to extract to the desktop. When you extract these files, they'll come in two flavors, shall we say. Some may come in as a folder within a folder with some instructions. Others may come in as just the folder with the building blocks in it. You need to find the folder that has just the building blocks, and that's the folder that you want to move into the Special Generations location. And that location is in SuperTech, and you can see that mine's located on the C drive. I've put a shortcut to it on the desktop. I also have a shortcut to my Gens EMB library because I get in these folders regularly. It's just easier to find them. So we'll open up SuperTech, and we'll go in Generations, and you see a building block folder. And this is where you want to copy this folder. Now, I'm not going to copy it in there because I already have one. I would like to also point out something else. This is exactly the way you would copy monogram frames, and monogram frames are in the monogramming folder. And we go in the background folder, and there you see a folder for each set of the monogram frames. Now, what's interesting is if you open up some of these frames, you'll see that they're also MNG format. MNG format is the same format we use for building blocks, so building blocks and monogram frames can be used interchangeably. Let's go back to Generations. Notice that my building block bar came up automatically, and that's because we had it open when we closed the last time. If you want to temporarily disable or hide your building block bar, just click the little X here. If you want to leave it off permanently, you'll want to go to View, Toolbar, and uncheck it here. Now, normally, once you add a building block group or folder to the building block folder in the SuperTech folder, it will show up automatically on your building block bar, and it should show up in alphabetic order. I have noticed that under certain circumstances, things don't show up in alphabetic order. They instead show up at the end. And that happened to me when I used this trick. So if you right-click on one of the tabs, you'll get this little pop-up contextual menu. And if it doesn't show up, or you have one that you've hidden for whatever reason, you can choose Insert Page. If you want to create a new group, you can do Add Page. When I did this, then Generations no longer put them in alphabetical order. Add Page will let you create a new group in the SuperTech folder. So let's choose Insert Page. And here you have a list of all of the folders in your building block folder. If for some reason your Generations version does not pop up to the building block folder, you just need to navigate. And once again, you'll go to SuperTech, Generations, and Building Block. One thing I didn't point out to you was when you copy folders into this building block folder, they need to be in the building block folder level. You can't put them inside, because if you have a folder within one of these other folders, it will not show up on this bar. So you just select the one you want, and it adds it. If you select one that you already have added, nothing happens. It won't duplicate it. To scroll in the building blocks bar, you can just hit the little arrows over here to the right. And if we go out here to where the ones that start with LG, these are all available, 1 through 10 at this time, are available on my website, and you can purchase them. I also have a free collection that you can download, and it's in the shopping cart as well. All the building blocks that I have on my site are available in MNG format. A couple of the later ones I've also included in Gen format, the native generations format. You cannot directly open an MNG file in generations. They have to be installed as building blocks. But once they are, then you can work with them just as you would any other generations file. So if we scroll out here to say the monogram frames, you may have seen another video where I just took one of these frames and turned it into an embossed monogram for towels. And once I drag it out there, you can see that it's just as if you had digitized it in generations yourself. So this is a great value of being able to find building blocks in native format. They can expand your creativity without having to digitize a design from scratch. So check out some of my other videos and see what you can do with building blocks. And if you'd like to learn more about building blocks and how to create your own, check out Unit 6 in the Learn to Digitize course. If you just need to get started learning your way around in generations, start with Unit 1. Unit 1 will get you off to a great start, and you'll be creating your first design within the first few pages.